Well, why don't we just, why don't we do this?
Policy, if we're running the ordinances, which is what's in there, that probably not take as long, because that one could be something that's just going to get added to the cost list and talk to more.
Okay. That'd be fine, we can do that.
If you're looking at what the shortest thing is, that's probably the shortest thing there.
We got about 15 minutes, we'll go ahead and get started with it. Let's, Paige, if you will, you put this all together, why don't you kind of give us a lead on the ordinance and what we're actually looking at and the discussion that we had as far as what we support that this is a different order?
Well, I would part of the first one to set it, but this is actually her, department.
With the,
This is the occupational tax ordinance, which makes people call business license, but it's really not, don't ever say it in front of all the time. But this was written in 1995, it really, really needs to be updated, sometimes it's kind of hard to understand and apply. Everything is based on business classes, which have changed a lot since 1995, so a lot of the problem that we have is trying to identify which class to put people in based on their business, because that business may not have existed in 1995. Also, this doesn't address solicitors or peddlers, which we had a proposal at one time to add that to the ordinance, but that never went through. But that is something that we run into more and more, is these door-to-door salespeople that don't actually have businesses in Lowndes County. They're coming in temporarily.
And one of the requests that we've had regarding that from the sheriff's office is a prohibition of people standing in intersections and collecting money. They continue to run people off whenever they start to do that, because it's very hard to know from an accountability standpoint if that money is actually being used for what they say. And in addition to that, it's a tremendous traffic hazard to just have people, you know, out in those intersections. And I think my sheriff's saying they're doing it out way out Bings Road at an intersection. So the sheriff's office has asked for our help if, you know, there's ever an opportunity just to say that can't be done here too. If we did that, and if we had code enforcement, but also, you know, running through these intersections and those people are doing that, if they were, you know, that could move them along as well.
You know, being in nonprofits and all, I realize a lot of people don't know that in order to have a raffle, you're supposed to go to the sheriff's office.
Yes, you're correct.
But these people show up so the drop tickets all the time. But they don't have a permit to drive this with
you. Yeah, you're right. And that permit's free. And it's just like, oh, you're correct.
These are items that, these ordinances that we have discussed with the attorney. And, we have not set a date, but we are trying to schedule a meeting with the attorneys, Stephanie and Paige and myself, to give them instructions on the timeline to get these back to the board members, to give you ample time to read them. But we also need input from the board if there are issues or concerns that you have had that we may not be aware of. We know what we're getting from the administrative end, but we don't know necessarily what you may have incurred. But these are all issues that are ordinances that are problematic right now.
Would this be taken to the next step, or from this standpoint, to take these ordinances and then other ordinances that we may identify to put that as a short-term goal, that we go ahead and review and revise if necessary these ordinances?
I think all of them at the point in time, we need to go back and look at your ordinances and see if they are still doing what you want them to do, if they are up to changes that may have been made.
Sure. And the reality is, I mean, there's sometimes you can look at an ordinance, and I'll just use this one and without having read all the way through it. An ordinance that was drafted in 1995, it could go either way. It could either, it, too restrictive as well as not clear enough and have enough information for the citizens to understand what classification they sit in or fall in. So it gives you an opportunity as well to look at that ordinance to see if it can be cleaned up and streamlined to make it more efficient for the citizens and staff to use.
Well, it's similar to our ULDC and the fact that Jason and staff review that and throughout the year issues, as you know, that have come up, they list those and then come back to you with a suggested change, amendment, or whatever.
Yep.
So I think that it's going to be necessary, yes, to review these and to put them on a more periodic review from the staff that are involved in that, and that they bring this back to
number one, our first.
When the ordinance saying we got to review our ordinance.
That's it.
Joe, have you identified anything in particular in the application of tax ordinance?
Oh.
We're trying to do this in 15 minutes now.
No. We, for instance, we've had people come in and as we were discussing earlier today, they have an online business. They're selling sports memorabilia. They're selling
I've got two complaints this week.
Or some of them are they don't gain access to it, they don't physically hold it, they just manipulate the sales and the shipment from point A to point B, but they're the ones who market it and it goes through them, so they're saying, well, I don't really have a business.
Well, all these direct marketers.
All these facial care.
So there's a lot of things that have popped up over the years with the change in the economy, as Harrison was alluding to today, of internet sales and things like that, that this particular agreement was written, was drawn up, this ordinance was drawn up in 1995, initially. So, yeah, there's a lot of things that have come along that we have to go back and look this up. And you probably would be surprised at the number of people that you are aware of that may not have a up-to-date and current license. And you would say, oh sure, they've been in business for so long. I'd go and ask for their license and see what happens. I didn't know I had a do you have to have a license?
They told me I didn't.
I know this, and I've seen it there. I mean, there probably might be interest in yours. If someone owes debt to the county, not being able to renew a business license. I mean, I just know of two instances within the city limits that people owe a lot of money, you know, from say a water bill debt that it just never did settle. They just started another person's name.
I think
another business.
I think Stephanie and I have four or five current business establishments that we are waiting to do something with them based on dealing with the attorney. Because, and they're saying, well, I didn't know I had that. I've got this corporation or this LLC, and then I had this other one over here, so this business license here should cover both of them. No, it doesn't. Well, why not? You're not going to make me pay twice, are you? You got two different businesses. What do you want me to do?
And you're not going to make me pay all this other that I owe and all the interest and penalties.
This says we go back 10 years. You're not going to make me pay back 10 years. I didn't know. So,
well, it's a little bit difficult for a business that's in the unincorporated area, but we may have to put some procedures in place at the same time so that we're able to notify those individuals. I know the city, for example, you don't get water and sewer and garbage pickup until you have a business license, for example. But in the unincorporated area, it's a little bit different because you can have a little operation, a welding shop or something, for example, and those folks just sit out and continue to do business with no business license whatsoever. And in all fairness to the other individuals in the unincorporated areas that do pay their business license, everybody needs to pay their business.
And that's been our argument to these individuals, or our point. You've got competitors that are paying theirs. Why should we not charge you just like we charge them? Well, but I didn't know any better.
Who checks to see if people are hurt?
Well, that's a little bit of what I'm saying. What we may have to do is look through the ordinance as we go as well. How can we improve our processes as well to see if there's a better way to make sure that when a business opens up, that they have to get a business license as well.
And the business license is annual?
Yes.
Yes.
But we can check and see if you're current. We do those. I mean, we send out renewal notices if you're in there. But if you decide, hey, I'm going to open a daycare center in my home, and you never come and get one until one of your clients gets upset with you and turns you in,
there's some we don't know. There are some that we send code enforcement, or we send the fire department has to make inspections on them, and that's one of the things that they look for. Show me your license.
But the way you catch how many years is whenever you do catch, they have to turn in their tax returns. And so then whenever you start looking at how many years of those they have, then you can tell how many years they've been in business.
I mean, sometimes we have one the other day where a man came in and he needed to get one because he had to get a full permit. But you can't pull a permit unless you have one. And just in the casual conversation of him trying to get his, well, you know, I've been in this business for like 20 years. Well, wait a minute.
Oh, you said what? What? What?
Give me your 2001 back.
But we do recognize the license of an individual that is in a municipality.
Yeah, if you already have one somewhere else that you're paying on, we'll give you one if you just pay the administration.
We have to.
Well, a lot of them on the street, right? I mean, I mentioned that I had a couple of complaints this week, and one of the legitimate citizens of the store, right? The other guy doing stuff out of the home, and they're saying, you know, and the crazy thing is they're all over Facebook promoting their business, and, you know, but yet they're not doing things necessarily
the right way. And the point is, things have changed since 1995 in that field, and we need to really go back and look at the process and look at the orders.
And if you want to look at, you're talking about revenue, can you imagine how much revenue we're missing in some cases? When you say, okay, this is based on your receipts from last year, we need to look at your taxes. They get really, really, really sloppy when it comes to keeping their records.
As far as delinquencies go, ones that have licenses are registered with us, 5 months ago, we probably had 130, 140 delinquents. And other than the five that we're waiting on, I think we have five. So at least we found those people and caught up with all of them in the last 4 or 5 months.
But they do pay us in a hurry.
When we clamp down on these five, y'all going to get calls.
These five are going to be fun.
You are going to get calls. I'll go ahead and tell you that.
Well, that's always a tough call. The reality is, they've been skating around the system for a number of years, and it's owed.
It's not fair to the people who have been.
That's correct. I go every single year to take a big fat check down to City Hall, the City of Valdosta. I take my financial statement down there every year, and I turn it over to them and give them that big fat check just so I can have my little green sticker that says occupational business license. Mm-hmm. And everybody else ought to do the same thing. Right, Mr. Grunner?
Yes, sir. We pay our year. and I pay for it, it's loop too, so I can't say, well, dealership's government, well, you can't work that way. Two checks.
Okay, Mr. Chair.
That's it?
Time.
Done. You're correct. All right, gentlemen, I and ladies, thank y'all very much for everything that you put together. We'll be back here in the morning at 8 o'clock, ready to get started. I hope you all are going to find a way to make it through the least dinner tonight.
What time?
Okay.
Seven to it.
I think it's at 6:00.
I think it's 6:30 that we're scheduled.
6:30, 20, I'm sorry, I think. Paige?
I got the ticket, sir.
Okay. You're that time.